How are you? Are you in Minnesota right now, or are you in New York?
No, I'm in Minnesota. So I'm here. I leave like late Wednesday night to go up to New York, and then we report Thursday morning.
Wow. Crazy.
Yeah, it's nuts. I can't believe it's already here. You know, it's a little earlier than normal anyways. Like, we have rookies, quarterbacks, injured players go Thursday, and then the rest of the vets don't come till next Tuesday, which is like the 27th. I think that's when the Vikings report too.
Okay.
So yeah, it's here and rapidly approaching. I feel like this like last week of summer is just always like so bizarre.
And are Jordan, the kids, going to stay here? Or are they going to come with you to New York for the season?
They'll come for the season, but they're not going to come up right away just because the first 2 weeks of training camp, I'm not home at all anyways. And then we actually, 2 of our 3 weeks in the preseason, were on the road, Cleveland and New England, and we're going there to practice during the week. So I'm hardly home until our, you know, last week of the preseason. So they're just going to come up then.
Well, that's cool. Good deal.
Yeah, well, it'll be fun.
Let's talk about – I want to talk about your this charity. First of all, the company, is it – how do you pronounce it? Is it Alltroo?
Alltroo, yeah, just Alltroo. Like altruistic.
Okay. It's a really cool idea. I think it's interesting. It's kind of a different – how did you come up with the idea to have experience-driven donations as opposed to just galas, auctions, and that kind of thing?
Well, I think the biggest thing is, you know, Jason Zucker, myself, and then our other two partners, John Wolberg and Joel Kunza, who are both partners of ours at University of Minnesota Masonic Children's Hospital. And Joel and John actually have a nonprofit, a 501c3 that's Athletes for Minnesota Kids. And, you know, this kind of all came up in January of this year. Their nonprofit wasn't able to do the normal golf outing that they do. They weren't able to put on the Give 16 awards that they did the year before. So a lot of their traditional fundraising, and this was true for all nonprofits really across the country and across the world, in-person events didn't happen for an entire year. A lot of people got creative and they did virtual events, but you know, charitable giving was one of the biggest things that got hit throughout the pandemic, just not being able to do things a conventional way. And so the four of us, you know, we came up, you know, kind of with this idea of like, you know, why, you know, when you go to those events, when you go to those galas, there's only a couple people that are sitting in the crowd who can actually afford these live auction items. We've all been to those events where, you know, most of the time the same 3 or 4 people are the ones that get to buy everything. And it's great. They can afford it. You know, a ton of money's raised for charity. But, you know, somebody that's just there to support the charity, they might not have an opportunity to win something like we're going to sweepstakes off this week at the 3M Open package. You know, we always say if we were to put this item in a live auction, you know, who knows how much it would go for, but the number of people who could afford it is so small. But then there's also so many people that are, you know, at the end of the month, they're looking to donate $5, $10, $25, $100 to charity, and they don't really know where to go with it or what organization to benefit. So, you know, taking all of those factors combined, we came up with Alltroo and a business model to where anyone can win. And, you know, whether there's somebody that enters for free, somebody that buys $5 worth of chances, or somebody that buys $300 worth of chances, you know, anyone can win a once in a lifetime experience, like walking inside the ropes at the 3M Open on Sunday. You know, having passes to the King's Corner, which are, you know, as exclusive as a ticket you can get for this weekend. So that was the biggest thing, is just, you know, the smallest of dollars are just important of the bigger dollars. And, you know, it'll be, we feel like we have something that's really special and we can raise a lot of money for charity.
It's kind of like a lottery of experiences, right? I mean, you can buy yourself as many tickets as you want. You can buy one, you can buy 1,000, but everybody has a chance.
So there's a lot of legal jargon that goes into it. So it's, it's a sweepstakes, and yeah. that's where it's capped. So that way, you know, theoretically everyone has the same chance to win, whether you enter for free or the max that you can buy is $300 worth of tickets. So, you know, we hope that, you know, like I said, this model can really impact the world of charitable giving. You know, like I said, so many people, you know, at least throughout my time, you know, I've talked to people that want to donate to the hospital, that want to do good, but they're like, oh, you know, I only have, you know, $30 at the end of the month, but I want to go to something that I'm passionate about. Or one of the things that we're going to do as we continue to build this is, you know, partnering with athletes. So many times in the locker room over the years, you know, young athletes want to get involved in an organization. Young athletes want to make an impact on their community. And what better way than create a really cool and unique experience with that athlete while raising hopefully a lot of money for charity as well. So, you know, like I said, Jason and I, you know, we've certainly done it the traditional way for a long time. But we feel like this is, you know, an opportunity where we can really, you know, I want to say disrupt the charitable giving market, but add a completely new dimension and hopefully take a market to the next level.
It's a genius idea. I mean, it certainly, I think, brings in more people. And then the, you know, the concept of is one person donating 10,000 equal to 10,000 people donating 30 or 300. So it's like, it's a really smart idea to kind of bring it to the masses and get everybody a chance to get more people, I would think, who wouldn't normally donate. Maybe now they will.
No, and that's exactly it. You know, is it easier as a nonprofit, a charity organization, to go find one donor to write a check for $10,000? Or, you know, can we go around and get 5,000 people to donate $2? You know, we want to try to do something that caters more to the masses. And then you add the experience and the prize side of things. And, you know, you get to provide a fan, if you would, or somebody that just, you know, enters because, you know, the sweepstakes that's running is benefiting an organization that they're passionate about. You can provide them with an experience that if this item was in a live auction or even a silent auction, you know, they'd probably never be able to afford it. So, you know, it's like I said, we're extremely excited about it. We feel like it can really impact the charitable giving world. Mm-hmm. And, you know, like I said, Jason and I did it the traditional way for a long time. And we know how hard it is for these organizations to continue to raise money traditionally. And there will always be a space for that. Yeah. But we feel like, you know, why not use our impact, our platform, to create something that can not only raise a ton of money for all different kinds of charitable organizations, but also provide that fan who is a Viking season ticket holder, but his season tickets are the 500 level at the top of the stadium. And, you know, maybe he can't afford to buy an experience like he could possibly win through Alltroo. So, you know, it's just something to cater to all sports fans, yeah. not just the ones that have the, you know, really nice Delta 360 club tickets that can buy whatever they want.
It's smart. And I know you, so you have this experience going on at the 3M Open. Tell me about that a little bit. I know we kind of glossed over a little bit. And then where do you see this going? I mean, how big, what kind of, I mean, I'm sure you and I know you and Jason, well, you guys, I'm sure you're always thinking about other things and other ideas. What's like the brass ring now that you're going for?
Well, like I said, for us, we're, you know, I use the word disrupt, but we're not, you know, we're trying to take the charitable giving market, if you would, and raise it to a whole nother level. You know, long-term, we'd love to do this to where, you know, there's some other people in this market that have raised hundreds of millions of dollars for charity. And, you know, that's our goal. Our goal is to impact not only the community that we live in here in Minneapolis, but, you know, communities that we play in, or, you know, with this type of a structure, it allows us to impact communities that we may never live in, work in, visit. But, you know, if we can partner with someone who's in that market or is passionate about that organization, it allows us to do that through this sweepstakes model. And that's the biggest thing, is just over the course of the last 16 months, you saw the charitable giving market just really come to a standstill. Mm-hmm. You know, a lot of the traditional things, I think for us, you know, our golf tournament, the Lake Bash, you know, Wine Fest, Fashion Fest, all those things for the hospital, we weren't able to do. And you know, it's like, it got our wheels turning a little bit, and how can we, no matter what's going on, how can we create something where, you know, if you have access to your cell phone, you can hop on and you can enter as many sweepstakes as you want and give to as many different organizations as you want. So we're extremely excited that we're able to kind of launch our platform and our company along with the 3M Open this week. And, you know, we're extremely excited about the prize too. The prize is as good as it gets. You know, you get two observer passes where on the final round on Sunday, you can walk inside the ropes with a group. So to have that kind of access, to be able to follow a group for 6 holes, 9 holes, 18 holes, whatever you want, it's completely up to you. You could follow them for their entire round. And then you also have two passes to the King's Corner, which I mentioned before. In my opinion, that's one of the best tickets of the weekend. All kind of great hospitality there. You can watch the rest of the groups come in throughout the course of the day. You know, it's lodging at the Lowe's Hotel downtown on Saturday night, and, you know, a gourmet meal in downtown Minneapolis at Fahima's, Chef David's restaurant, who has always been so good to both Jason and I and all the charitable work that we've done. So, you know, what better way to kind of, you know, kick off our new venture by partnering with the 3M Open, having some of our local partners here, like the Lowe's Hotel and Chef David, to just create, you know, even if you're not a golf fan, it's kind of a cool little getaway for one night in a day to really have a good time. And like I said, if you're not a golf fan, you might end up being a golf fan after walking inside the ropes and seeing how good these guys really are. Because they always make it look so easy on TV. You don't get a good appreciation for it.
Well, you know that firsthand, playing in the Celebrity Classic. Although was that chip out of the bunker, it was pretty sweet.
Oh, thank you. You know, certainly you can tell what a different world it is. You know,
yeah.
One of the things that we get to do this week is, you know, we're having the Compass Challenge, which is Josh Duhamel and his team of Amanda Baliones, Larry Fitzgerald, Joe Mauer against Team Rudolph, which is myself, Annika Sorensen. Her back's going to be sore after this. We're going to, you know, make sure that she's carrying the team. But then Adam Thielen, as well as Charles Barkley. And it's just something, you know, one of the things that in my opportunity to be the 3M ambassador, we wanted to find, again, another way to raise more money for charity. And the 3M Open Fund does amazing work here in the Twin Cities, you know, benefiting a lot of local programs, one of which is the hospital at the University of Minnesota. So it was something that I, you know, we had done out a couple years, and it was like, why not bring it here and bring, you know, local celebrities, but also we have a couple of national celebrities that'll get to come in and see what Minnesota's like in the summertime. And you know, I said this after the 3M Open the first year. Unfortunately, we weren't able to have fans last year. But the first year, to see Minnesota sports fans out at the course, you know, they love the game of golf. Summertime is the best time in Minnesota, and you get to go out and really celebrate summertime on the golf course and watch some of the best players in the world. The field is outstanding this year, and they couldn't have had a more difficult week to get guys to come, being sandwiched in between the Open Championship over in England and the Olympics in Tokyo. So it really speaks volumes to the 3M Open and everybody there that they were able to get some top tier talent here this week.
So just logistically for my purposes, so does it open tomorrow? Is that what you said? It opens tomorrow?
Correct. It'll be live Tuesday through, okay. I believe it's Friday night or Saturday morning. I need to double check that. Cool. But yeah, it'll run during the week. The winner will be announced Saturday. And that's part of the reason why, you know, we're doing this one just in the state of Minnesota. Mm-hmm. You know, theoretically you're here locally. You can do a little staycation at the Lowe's Hotel, grab a bite to eat on Saturday night. And then, you know, we'll provide transportation to and from the hotel out to the course. And I think it'll be a really, really cool experience. Like I said, even if you're not a golf fan, it's a cool kind of getaway. And then the golf is just a bonus on top of it. Being able to have that kind of access, being able to walk inside the ropes is pretty special.